in place, with doctors ready to test possible cases immediately.
This treatment center is now seeing about 400.
This pathogen does not wait to attack.
It's become a global pandemic.
The pandemic clock is ticking, and we don't know when the next pandemic will occur. It could occur tomorrow.
Without any question, it's the single thing on Earth that poses the greatest threat to the most humans.
Most of us see the flu as a seasonal annoyance.
The flu has become a generic term for I'm not well. And that's a problem because people live through the I'm not wells. They have a yucky week and then they go back to work.
But the reality of this disease is much more grim. Influenza is highly infectious and deadly.
Every year we have outbreaks of influenza, and periodically we have pandemics that create enormous amounts of death and illness.
This is a very important public health issue. Last year, we estimate that over 80,000 Americans died from seasonal flu. That is nothing compared to what a serious flu pandemic could be like.
This organism has global consequences, not only for health, but for economies, for security, and for the well-being of all societies. The impact is that large.
It is a killer. And there are times when it becomes not just a seasonal disease, but it becomes a pandemic. And in the case of 1918, a pandemic that killed 50 million people.
No disease outbreak in modern history has claimed more lives than the Spanish flu pandemic. During its two-year terror, the influenza virus spread rapidly, infecting 500 million people, killing otherwise healthy adults within hours of feeling ill.
This is a disease that we have seen devastate populations and communities. Every expert in the field of influenza says it's not a matter of if, but when we experience the next pandemic.
We've been lucky for the last 100 years that we haven't had a pandemic of the magnitude of 1918. But if we were to have one, it would be catastrophic.
With the way we live now, the speed we travel, the next influenza outbreak could spread to every major urban city within 6 months.
We have airplanes now. A flu virus that breaks out in Taiwan is in New Jersey in 2 days. It's the thing that's most likely to be lethal rapidly to millions of people. And unless we do something to change the way we're doing business now, that is going to happen.
We don't know when the next pandemic is going to hit. It could hit at any time. And although we have many good flu vaccines today, they aren't at the place they need to be to protect us from a pandemic.
They are imperfect. They're based upon our best guess of what strain will be prevalent in any particular year.
One of the things about influenza that is different, say, from measles or mumps are pretty much the same virus that affects all people. In influenza, the viruses have a lot of slight modifications, and that is why we need to come up with a vaccine that has broad protection that is able to cover all of those modifications. That's a universal influenza vaccine.
We need a vaccine that is more protective, lasts longer, and will be effective against any influenza virus. That's the universal flu vaccine we seek.
Which is why Sabin launched the Influenzer Initiative, a groundswell campaign to disrupt the way we approach influenza, to bring together the world's top thinkers to jumpstart the development of the first universal influenza vaccine, a vaccine that provides longer-lasting immunity against many strains, even as they mutate.
This is not just incrementalism. This is not just doing a little bit better. What we're aiming to do is a log step forward. And by putting together non-traditional ways of thinking, that's how we're going to drive to a faster solution.
This is a critical time to think about how can we move forward. And clearly what we need to do is mobilize a set of experts, a set of stakeholders, a set of big thinkers to actually address and solve this problem.
Indeed, I believe that bringing together people from a wide cross-section of backgrounds and disciplines is the most promising way to bring about significant scientific progress.
This is going to take a major team effort. As a scientific community, as a business community, as an advocacy community, we all need to be together in making sure that we don't waste a moment of time.
Passionate, talented people coming together just for this cause is what we need to solve this very important problem.
Together, we're establishing new integrated networks that both complement and challenge traditional research avenues. A convergence revolution, an unprecedented collection of knowledge, theory, methodology, and talent, all working together to accelerate the development of a next-generation influenza vaccine.
A universal influenza vaccine is a goal that would be an outrageous goal. It would be an audacious goal. It would be a transforming goal for public health and for the health of countries and families. It's a goal that's within our reach. It's a goal that's attainable.
I think it's possible, and I think we just have to take advantage of the talent that's out there and bring them together to work on universal flu.
It is possible, desirable, and I believe necessary to develop the universal flu vaccine that will stop influenza from being the deadly disease it is.
And if we can do that, we will, as a society, achieve one of the greatest public health victories that we've ever known.
This is a call to arms, an invitation to be part of something bigger than yourself, and bigger than the flu. By building on each other's discoveries, we can help make influenza history.
We need to work together, and we need to do it now.
Do you want to save the world? You know, we could be devastated at any moment by a pandemic.
So why wouldn't you want to be one of the people who prevents that for all time?
Help shape the future of health. Be an influencer. Get involved now at influenza.org.